every act of the Lord which he did. Therefore, you shall keep every commandment which I command you today, that you may be strong and go in and possess the land which you cross over to possess, and that you may prolong your days in the land which the Lord swore to give your fathers, to them and their descendants, a land flowing with milk and honey. For the land which you go to possess is not like the land of Egypt, from which you have come, where you sow your seed and water it by food, a vegetable garden. But the land which you cross over to possess is a land of hills and valleys, which drinks water from the rain of heaven, a land for which the Lord your God cares. The eyes of the Lord your God are always on it, from the beginning of the year to the very end of the year. And it shall be that if you earnestly obey my commandments, which I command you today, to love the Lord your God and serve him with all your heart and with all of your soul, then I will give you the rain for your land in its season, their little rain and the later rain that you may gather in your grain, your new wine in your own. I will send grass in your fields for your livestock that you may eat and be fed. Now here we are, you can see today, as we read this word of God, certain nations against this whole country of Israel, with a total combined strength of troops, 547,000 troops and 240,000 were deployed. I want you to hear this. 13 nations, big nations against tiny nation of Israel, by the help of God and by the faith of Israel to the God of Abraham, to the God of Moses, to the God of Jacob, and by Israel sudden attack, like Joshua in the Old Testament, I want you to see the amazing result. Israel captures the Gaza Strip in the Sinai Peninsula from Egypt, the West Bank, including East Jerusalem from Jordan, and the Golan Heights from Syria. Listen to this. Israel cuts off this 983 persons killed and thousands wounded, compared to the five poor nations strong and nine nations supporting them behind. The United Arab world, Egypt, Jordan, Syria, and Iraq, 33,500 soldiers were killed. 1,021 captured, hundreds of tanks destroyed. Now I use this offensive warfare of Israel against the big nations surrounding her, for I will cite parallelism or likeness or similarity concerning the war that you and I are facing against Satan, against yourself or your old nature, or against the sin that masters you and I, and the alarming sinful lifestyle of the world today that is affecting the believers in Jesus Christ. Now the word that we're going to dissect, once you embrace, once you have acted upon in your life, the result is you'll experience these two destructive things today. Number one, you'll experience a life of power against the onslaught of Satan. There is an attack to assault you of a violent nature and vigorous force from Satan that with the intent to slaughter and kill the believers. So you have the power to fight back in the counterattack Satan. Number two, because of this study, you have a life of power over the annoying, disturbing habits we always culture almost every week and every month. Now probably there's a question, is there a remedy? I've been falling short over and over again with this kind of problem every day, every week, every month, every year. Is there any solution? Is there a discipline that I can be entered into that will take me out of this mess or this cycle month after month? The answer is absolutely yes, and the answer is in the scripture this morning. So in verse 12, as you read again in the book of Ephesians, verse 12, go back to verse 12, as you can see there. Follow me there. Very powerful word. The answer is here in verse 12. According to the eternal purpose which he accomplished in Christ Jesus, in whom we have the boldness, number one, we have the access, number two, we have the confidence, number three, through faith in him. Therefore, I ask you that you do not lose heart at my tribulation for you, which is your glory. Number one answer for this kind of mess and problems of concerning Satan in ourselves is, number one, The door of blessing is widely open for you and for me in heaven, and you are recipient of that. Now, Satan's influence is control. When God is for us, one of the wonderful messages there this morning about the presence of God, when God is for us, who shall be against us? Now, notice the two important words used by the Apostle Paul to give strength to the point. Paul is trying to communicate to every heart of the believers to understand, first is the word boldness. The other translation is fearlessly. And the other word that Paul is using is access. And the third word to give is strength to give in truth is confidence, which will not disappoint you. Now the word access implies in Greek language is a proper introduction into the presence of a monarch or king, put it in an earthly sphere. In the earthly kingdom today in England or in Denmark or the modern family in Sweden, to come to the place where the head of the kingdom and family reside, it is impossible to be entertained, it is impossible to be welcomed, it is very, very foreign that you'll be given an opportunity to see the family in that kingdom. Without any satisfying reason that interests the king or the queen, you will never be accepted, welcomed, or given the right to see them in person. Now the proper introduction, listen to this, as we receive, for all of us to come to the most holy place and then present my knee in your knees and then ask some help about your problem, the Father God, the creator of the heavens and the earth, who is absolutely holy, sitting at the throne of his glory, the door is now widely open because of Christ who fulfilled the will of God, who died on the cross, and then he was buried and rose again, giving us the opportunity to be adopted into the family of the Lord, children of God, sitting at the right hand of the Father, listen to this, interceding, doing the petition every day for you, that God will protect you until the day of his appearing. Now, his sacrificial offering in his body and blood paved the way for all of us, no exception. There is no kind of bias or prejudice or favoritism before God, whether new or old, used by that mind for many years. God is saying to you, you are special to me. The door is wide open to his own people, to those who are accepted without prejudice and beloved of God. Now, you are accepted without question. Why, Pastor? Because the Holy Spirit, the third person of the Trinity, is given to you, which is a down payment of his purchased possession. You are bought with a price, a guarantee that you belong to God and God is your Father. He gives us the Word of God as a sword to cut the forces and paralyze the satanic kingdom. So victory, victory, victory is for you and for all of us. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Victory is for you, accepted. Now Hebrews 10:19-20, the following, this is our Word of God. Brothers and sisters, therefore, brethren, take up the word boldness. There's already a big open deal like heaven, having boldness under the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way, which he consecrated for us through the veil that is his flesh, and having a high priest over the house of God, let us look at the word invitation, lovingly, cheerfully, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance. There is no rejection. There is no demarcation line. It's wide open. Assurance of faith, having our hearts is sprinkled from evil conscience and our bodies washed with the pure water. Full assurance, for he promised, the one who promises faithful, there is assurance. In other words, God is saying you can come to him boldly, is secure, because he can be trusted to keep his promises. In Jeremiah 29:11 says, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. See the word of God there, Jeremiah. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord. thoughts of peace and other people to give you a future and a hope. Well, for I know the plans I have for you, God says, revealing to us, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope in a future. Now the Word of God, the Holy Spirit is a down payment. You are owned by God. The Word of God is guaranteed in your life today, guaranteed tomorrow, and guaranteed in the future. It is like a blank check signed by the Trinity, signed by Jesus Christ. No amount written, but given to hand it down to you, and it's up to you to put the amount you want to put in there for your needs as long as you live in the planet Earth. Enjoy the provisions, for it is fully funded by the Bank of Heaven. Fully funded by the Bank of Heaven. There are more than 7,000 living promises of God, and the promises are for you to take and enjoy from the standpoint unto the coming of the Messiah to take his very own. Jeremiah 29:13, now you will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. Now many of you today have experienced God's protection and provision. I believe many of you. I know that. And I hope you won't forget that kind of blessing in your life to testify that you are the apple of God's eye. A story that happened to us in 1993 in Alberta, Canada, going down to the border of America. Satan planned in 1993, in the month of November 3, 1993, Satan planned to destroy and kill me and another friend, an ex-Navy, retired Navy by the name Jim Bunga, a good friend, dedicated servant of God, retired Navy, who drove back to America from Alberta, Canada. We had a good time meeting at the Billy Graham meeting of all the 900 pastors all over America who went to that place. Many pastors at the different places of Canada, and people, many missionaries and ministers all over the world. We had such a good time meeting these ministers all over the world. It was a memorable and refreshing time together, a time of celebration, and the power of the Holy Spirit that touched the lives of many ministers. We are so blessed. And I'm getting ready to drive back to America, by the way, to Seattle. Here, Seattle in California. Few months before we approached the border of America, Jim Bunga lost control of our small car. Now the car going down here turned around and were traveling backward 50 kilometers per hour. God is the witness of this testimony. Seeing the cars of big trucks going uphill, we're facing the same direction because we're down here backward 50 kilometers per hour. The same direction toward Canada we're facing there, but we're traveling backward going to America. Now, there was no traction on the wheels of our car, and Jim Bunga started to pray. Jesus, I pray in Jesus' name. And Jim Bunga said, Jesus. And again I said, in Jesus' name. I pray in Jesus' name. And then what happened here is that Jim Bunga, now in my prayer, Jim Bunga, the third time he said, Jesus, my prayer was in the subconscious of my brain, all over my system, when I call upon Jesus, there's no statement or long sentence that I could utter in my mouth. When I say, Jesus, I rebuke the demon of death. Why Jim Bunga, according to you, when you say, Jesus,